Stapp explored pilot ejection seats, liquid oxygen breathing systems, tested the impact of wind blast, and subjected a succession of Air Force personnel to all manner of experimental contortions. But he spent the most time studying G-force limits, how the intense acceleration and deceleration encountered in a rocket or high-speed jet affected the human body. The military maintained that any force beyond 18 Gs, or 18 times the pull of gravity, would be fatal. Stapp helped design a series of faster and faster rocket sleds to challenge that assumption.
Imagine a soapbox racer made of aluminum on a railroad track with rockets on the back of it, which would be fired down the track and then slammed to a stop in just a few seconds.
Stapp rode the sleds himself, each time ramping up the speed and the G-force pressing on his body. He cracked ribs, lost six fillings, and broke both of his wrists. "I prefer to take the physical punishment personally," he told one observer, "rather than risk the court-martial for killing some unlucky sergeant."
He got up to over 300 miles an hour and pulled 38 Gs. And when he told his superiors that he had survived 38 Gs, they told him to cease and desist immediately.
Stapp used to say, "I always follow orders when they make sense." And he always pushed it a little farther than his superiors were comfortable with.
On December 10th, 1954, Stapp took his experiment to its extreme.
There were 9 rocket engines on the back of that sled. And when they fired, Stapp said that he lost all orientation as he shot on this track in excess of 630 miles per hour. At the end of the track, Stapp slammed to a full stop in 1.35 seconds.
It was the equivalent to ejecting from an airplane at 30,000 feet. And he was out to prove that a pilot could do that in an ejection seat and survive.
The most serious thing that happened was the hemorrhaging into his retinas. He got out of the rocket sled. He thought he was permanently blind.
He was taken to the base hospital, where gradually his vision came back. He had 2 black eyes, but other than that, he was fine.